want to ask, not ask, I think there is a learning for each and everybody in every walks of life, right? And this learning comes in a, either in a bitter way or sometimes in a good ways. So there is a phrase by John Collin. The real mistake we do when we learn nothing. The real mistake we do when we learn nothing. So this is the phrase by John Collin. So friends, today my topic is learning from the mistake. So learning from the mistake, since I came down to Chennai in 2007, and subsequently I was able, or I would say I am one of the fortunate person among the few to be safe standing in front of you all sharing my experience. So learning from the mistake, I have taken the topic. I want to just take you through one small incident. I think everybody will be aware of Chennai flood.
Yeah.
Right. It was one of the natural devastating disaster for the Chennai in a century. It was really horrible, and I was fortunate. I was stranded in my flat nearly for 7 days, and it taught me a lot of lessons. Really, first time in my life I have 4 lessons for me. I can remember, it was December 28, 2015. So there was a rain from near about last couple of 30 days, and that day my wife also told. So if I see, means how you feel, means you are seeing that day by day the water level is going up. Okay, and this disaster is something that you are seeing it and you have a time, and if you don't take the precaution or you don't take the action, it will lead to a disaster. So when, what happens, the difference between earthquake and flood is that earthquake immediately instinct and then it goes back to normal. You can see the person and you can see the movement, it all of a sudden get disturbed and then it comes back, right? So but in flood it's totally different story. Slowly, slowly it goes up. So I also went to office. My wife told me, no, don't go to office, but I told, okay, let me go up. So it was raining heavily. So after some point of time, media started disclosing that it's a water is out of danger level. So people should not move here and there. Little be on the safest area. Ensure that you are in a water-free zone. Water-free zone means where there is you are away from the water bodies. So our bus started from the plant. We are about it's supposed to start by 5:30, but it started by 4:30. Seeing the severity of the water, and I reached at 10 o'clock at home. Believe me, I came by bus, and I need to walk down near about 800 meters from the stoppage to my house. An entire stretch, full, the road was under the water of 3 feet, and I was literally carrying the bag and just walking down. And when I walked down to house, so my wife was eagerly waiting, and she all of a sudden hugged me, and all of a sudden I realized what is the value for me, for my family, what is the value I hold for the family. In fact, these are all things we don't realize in our day-to-day life, because every day we are seeing what is that will come back and all this thing. But she knows that something is going wrong, and he will come safe or not, there's a question mark in her mind. But I was having no question in my mind. She is safe over there, so I never thought of it. Right? Is that making sense to you all?
Yes.
Yeah. So this was one of the real learning that, yeah, you have a value for your family. You deserve one value for your family, and it's not only the money part. So we were there in 7 days in that condition when there was no money, no water. In fact, people were laughing. Water was near abundance. And no electricity. And my two kids, they also understood what is the natural calamity. They also at very early stage, I think one is in 10 years, another one is 8 years, right? So it's too early for them to understand because I never felt like that. So I can correlate why my parents used to say. Actually, my parents migrated from Bangladesh to West Bengal. So that time they used to tell, that we used to carry a bag and in the dark we used to run, walk down to the things, and we didn't realize. But that day we realized what is a thing without light, without power, yeah, with limited money, and with limited water, and with limited food too. Because we don't have any food, vegetable is not there, only some pulses and rice is there. So that was the thing, we managed it well. And another lesson we got from it is that it was like a sharing. Whatever we eat, we are ensuring that nothing is thrown out, no wastage, all are sharing equally, and ensuring that everybody's stomach is topped up. And subsequently, our neighbor is also well placed, means he is also having stuffs. So we are asking each other. Here, the humanity comes into picture. So that was the good part of it. Then third thing, when we saw if we see around ourselves, there were a lot of people having a lot of imported cars and all this thing. 2-3 cars, everything drawn out. Totally washed away, because you know nowadays, today's world, the car are too much having electronic gadgets. So when the water pressure build up, the door automatically opens. So you have 1.5 crore car. So it happened, I've seen in my eyes. So the thing which I learned is that you should have that much value which you can bear the loss.
Correct.
Right? And prepare yourself for any disaster. Be ready for any disaster. You will not believe, we never thought of having a candle at home. But from that day, first day onwards, when we are stranded inside our house, we are searching for the candle and we got 2 candles. You will not believe, we got only 2 candles. And we know if I light that candle, it's going to last one another 2 hours. And every day, morning we wake up, we feel that today electricity will come, power will get restored. With that hope, we leave for the 7 days with the same stuff, with the same money. So it's possible. When crisis is there, everything is possible. We'll manage accordingly. So that was a good lesson which we learned. Subsequently, you know the figures, why it has happened. Is anyone aware of this? Why it has happened? How all of a sudden the natural disaster came? How it has converted
to
the dams? The dam issue.
Yeah. Exactly. So you'll not believe. Chennai. Later on, we discovered, once we our power got restored, we found that Chennai before it was having 450 water bodies, and when this situation prevailed, that time the present was only 50 water bodies. What is the percentage? You hope encroachment. It comes about near about 94%. So this is the level of encroachment we did, and we call it as a natural disaster. I don't think it is a natural disaster. It's a man-made disaster, right? So this is the figure, and because of this man-made disaster, man paid off. 500 people died, and 1.8 million people were displaced. They were washed away and kept stranded in different locations. So all of this happened because we are not able to, the entire city, municipality was not able to manage the thing. It would have been contained. We are very near to the sea. It's very easy to dispose the water. But we are not able to do so. So for me, it's a man-made disaster. What do you think about it?
Yes.
Exactly. So my friends, How do you feel? How much you are ready about it? Are you ready today for to face any disaster?
No.
So I pray to God you should not have this type of experiences. But stay ready. Stay ready. Don't be ready.